A devotee asked Sri Bhagwan Raman Maharshi, "How does the repetition of the name of God help realization?" Sri Bhagwan replied, "The original name is always going on spontaneously without any effort on the part of the individual. That name is Aham, I. But when it becomes manifest, it manifests as Ahamkar, the ego. The oral repetition of the name leads one to mental repetition, which finally resolves itself into the eternal vibration. The mind or the mouth cannot act without the self." Thereupon, Sri Bhagwan told the following story. Tukaram, the great Maharashtra saint, used to remain in Samadhi in the day and sing and dance at night with the large crowds of people. He always used to utter the name of Sri Ram. Once he was answering the call of nature and also saying Ram, Ram. An orthodox priest was shocked at the uttering of the holy name by the saint when his body was not clean. Hence, he reprimanded him and ordered him to be silent. Tukaram said, "All right," and remained mute. But at once there arose the name of Ram from every pore of Tukaram, and the priest was horrified by the din. He then prayed to Tukaram, "Restrictions are only for the common people and not for saints like you." My dear brothers and sisters, chanting God's name is the boat that helps us ferry across the ocean of life. Chanting purifies the antahkaran, the inner sense organs consisting of the conscious mind, subconscious mind, intellect and ego, making it capable of receiving spiritual knowledge. Just as one cannot reap a good harvest without ploughing the field to make it fertile, similarly, knowledge cannot penetrate the antahkaran until it is purified. Hence, it is necessary to remain steadfast unto the practice of karma, bhakti, worship of God, singing bhajans, kirtans, etc. Keep chanting the name of the God. Jai Shri Krishna.